Something's got to be done about these holdups and killings, or we're going to have to take the law into our own hands.
What's the matter with the Rangers?
Yeah, all they do is ride around and look important.
I agree with you, gentlemen. It's about time we did something to protect ourselves. I realize that the Rangers seem to be helpless.
We know that, Martin. But if something isn't done, there's no telling which one of us is liable to get killed next.
Before we make any move, suppose we have another talk with Captain McDowell. If we can't get any satisfaction from him, there's only one alternative. Take the law into our own hands.
Across the plains of Texas, with rustlers on the run, the Rangers join together to rule by law and gun.
And we go riding, 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 swinging in the saddle, eager for a battle. Riding, 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 riding all day long.
We live where duty calls us, from sun to setting sun. A ranger's never weary when there's duty to be done.
Then we go riding, 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 swinging in the saddle, eager for a battle. Riding, 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 riding all day long.
We sleep beneath the heavens, and at the crack of dawn, the trails again are calling, and soon we're moving on.
And we go riding, 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 swinging in the saddle, eager for a battle. Riding, 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 riding all day long. Riding, 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 with our ranger song.
If you don't quit stealing Singlo's pies, he's going to work you over one of these days.
Your dad don't mind.
Hokey Blake, you're stealing Captain Pie. Someday me catch him, you cut him up like fine peas, make him tap suey.
Oh, shuck, Singlo. You wouldn't kill a man with an empty stomach, would you?
You wait, me fix it. Me all the time make pie for Captain. You all the time eat, you pig. Me butcher you like steer. We're calling on you, what all of us. We're calling on him, dog. Holy wa. You remember that, huh?
The old man's been yelling for you, Brand. Looks like you got an assignment.
Thanks. I'll be right in. Wait for me, Steve.
Hello, Brand.
Hello, Joanne. It's nice seeing you again. How's Dad?
Well, he's terribly worried about the trouble those outlaws are causing.
Yes, I know how he feels. But we're doing our very best.
I know you are. That's what I keep telling him.
Every time we think we have them, they strike in another direction. It looks like they know every move we make. Listen, I got to get in and see the captain. He just sent for me.
Do you think he can come out to dinner tonight?
If he doesn't send me out on an assignment, I'll be happy to.
Good. Bring Steve with you.
Thanks. You sent for me, sir?
Calhoun, you know what we're up against.
Yes, sir, I do.
This gang of outlaws are well organized. In order to break it, we've got to find the leader. That's your assignment. Do you think you can handle it?
Yes, sir.
I should send a couple of men with you. But as you know, we're short-handed.
I understand, sir.
Watch yourself, Brand. This is a dangerous assignment. Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Well, fellas, I'm going away for a few days.
Can I go along?
No, Steve. This is a ranger's job. See you when I get back.
Good hunting, Brand.
Thanks.
There's a real ranger.
Porky, do you think I'll ever be a ranger and see some action?
Sure, you'll see plenty of action if you ever go manhunting with that brother of yours. Wherever he is, things just generally start humming.
I'm gonna follow him.
You're gonna follow him. Hey, wait a minute. You'll stay here if you know what's good for you.
You can have your gold and wealth untold and all that it can buy, but I'd trade the whole darn gold supply for a huckleberry pie. Though a sultan thrives on 40 wives, I wouldn't be that guy, 'cause the only thing for which I sigh is a huckleberry pie. Just plain or with a la mode, I'd like 6 or 7. I'd eat and eat till I explode into huckleberry heaven. Let the other fools collect their jewels, but I wouldn't even try, 'cause the only thing for which I cry is a huckleberry pie. I dream of a lovely crust, yum, 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 yummy. But when I rake, the lovely crust ain't nowhere in my tummy. And if you should say you have today one wish before you die, I would stand up straight and my reply would be huckleberry pie.
What are you doing here? I thought I left you at headquarters.
Oh, it won't hurt if I go along this time. Honest, I won't get in your way.
All right. You can camp with me tonight. But in the morning, I'm going to see that you get back to the post.
All right.
What's up, boss?
Palaverde Stage will be carrying the mine payroll in the morning.
What about the Rangers?
Don't worry about them. They're holding a meeting with the local citizens sometime tomorrow. That'll keep them busy.
Good.
Come from Alabama with my banjo on my knee. I'm going to Louisiana, my true love now to see. Oh, Susiana, don't you cry for me. I come from Alabama with my banjo on my knee. It rained all night the day I left, the weather it was dry. Sun so hot I froze to death, Susanna, don't you cry. Oh, Susanna, don't you cry for me. I come from Alabama with my banjo on my knee.
There she is. All right.
right, Doc. Get down on the road. Like a frame up.
What do you mean?
The stage is due by there any minute now. I'm going down to see what it's all about.
I'm going with you.
No, you keep out of this. If anything should happen to you, Steve, I'd never forgive myself.
Too close to that ranger station to suit me.
Oh, don't you worry, kid. I'll get you back to the post in no time. Here, get comfortable.
Thank you.
with you?
Sing Low chopped my hand off with a cleaver.
Oh, I don't believe it. Let me see. There's nothing the matter with your hand.
He missed.
Sorry we have to do this, but there's no other choice in the matter.
Father in?
Yes, Mr. Rollins, he's waiting for you.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Captain.
How are you, Joanne?
Fine, thank you.
Captain, those outlaws are at it again, and we want some action.
The people are thoroughly aroused. They're beginning to talk vigilante law.
I'm not trying to excuse the failure of my men for not bringing in these outlaws. But the trouble is, we've got only a handful of rangers to cover this entire territory.
We appreciate your position, Captain. But I'm afraid if you don't break up these raiders, the people will organize.
Into a holdup.
Well, what was Steve doing with you?
Thank you, gentlemen. I've assigned Calhoun to the job. I'm sure that we'll have some good news for you soon. I'm sorry, Brand. I'm afraid there's nothing we can do.
That doesn't help much, Captain. You can have my resignation.
Wait, Brand. You don't mean that.
Every word of it. Expecting one man to do the work of 10. I'm through. There's my star.
What are you doing here?
I thought I told you to keep a lookout at the entrance.
Say, them rangers couldn't find this place in a million years.
You put a guard out there and keep him there, do you understand?
Sure, boss, sure. Sorry we missed on that stagecoach job.
Maybe you didn't.
What do you mean?
Calhoun quit the Rangers. He was the best man McDowell had.
That's good news. What are you gonna do about it?
I've arranged a meeting with the ranchers and townspeople. If everything works out right, I'll be the law in Palo Verde.
Patty, have you heard anything from Brand?
No, he simply rode away.
Nobody's seen hide nor hair of him since.
I'm worried about him.
Oh, he'll be all right.
Is your dad coming to the meeting?
No, he's out on patrol, but Porky and I are coming. We'll follow you in.
Hi, Rollins.
Pretty near 2 o'clock. Martin will be here any minute now, and then we can get down to business.
Oh.
How do you do, Mr. Rollins?
Hello, Martin.
Hello. Patty. It's Joanne.
How do you do?
Take your seats, folks. Friends, this is no time for idle talk. We're getting no protection from the Rangers. I believe Captain McDowell should be replaced by a more competent man.
Just a minute, Mr. Martin. You're not giving my father a square deal. You know he's done everything.
We'll have open session later, Miss McDowell. Please sit down.
I will not sit down. You're condemning my father without giving him a chance to speak for himself. And I'm going to have my say.
I can understand Miss McDowell's feelings. But obviously, the situation has become more than your father can handle.
That isn't true.
Here, here, stop. Take it away. Take it away. Miss Joanne.
Now, we have no further outbursts of sentiment. We can proceed without interruption.
What's your plan, Martin?
We are forced to organize for the protection of our lives and property. I propose that we bring in our own law enforcement agency. I've contacted such a group and they await our call. Naturally, it will be necessary to contribute to the upkeep of this organization. But I'll start the ball rolling with a personal contribution of $1,000.
That's a lot of money.
It'll be worth every cent to remove the constant threat of an outlaw raid over us.
Count me in for $500. It's good insurance for my bank.
That's the ticket. I knew I could count on you.
We'll show them we mean business in Palo Verde. Pass the hat.
I got a gal in the Sawwood Mountain.
Heidi Odi in Lumbee.
So many pretty gals I can't count 'em.
Heidi Odi in Lumbee.
I got a gal at the head of the holler.
Heidi Odi in Lumbee.
She won't come and I won't follow.
Heidi Odi in Lumbee.
My true love is a sunburned daisy.
Hidey o diddlum day.
He won't work and I'm too lazy.
Hidey o diddlum day.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You've been very generous.
Calhoun!
Hold it, Martin.
I'll take care of that money.
Bram will turn outlaw.
Dad, I just don't understand.
Shh.
a pretty good bandit.
Well, that just goes to show you what kind of men McDowell had under him.
I wouldn't say that, Mr. Martin.
I'm not so sure he is a bandit.
Captain, I can't figure Brand turning outlaw.
I guess he just turned bad after what happened to his brother. I've got every man at the post looking for him.
Boys, something has got to be done about Calhoun.
Yeah, he's beating us to the punch on every job you tip us off to. The boys are restless. Calhoun's getting all the money.
I know that, and it's up to us to catch up with him. Now listen, I got a line on the express company. They're storing a big payroll that we can use.
When do we take it?
Tonight. Now, this is one job that Calhoun won't beat us to.
Calhoun again. There's our chance.
Boys caught up with me.
It's about time.
What are you going to do about it?
We'll decide that later. Right now, we're taking him to the hideout. Put him on his horse, boys.
Start moving.
Finally got Calhoun.
Good.
What do you want me to do with him? Finish him off?
Oh, I've got a better plan. See if we can get him to join the gang. Have a talk with him. You know, string him along.
What do you want to do that for?
There's a lot of reward money offered for him. When we get through around here, we'll turn him in and collect.
I see. Make him the goat and put us in the clear. See you later.
Say, sing low. How about me and you having a nice sociable game of draw poker, huh?
Me no savvy poker.
You no savvy poker? That's all right. I'll teach you the game.
Me no savvy. Me bloke.
You bloke? What do you mean, bloke? You're never bloke as long as you got nice cookies like that around. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll teach you the game and you bet for the cookies. What do you say?
Me don't know. Me savvy.
Come on, be a good fella. Sit down. Sit down. This game is going to be on the up and up. I'll see to that.
Me see too.
Well, let's see how many cookies you got over here. Empty. see. I'll just bet a chip against five more cookies.
Okie dokie, me call.
Wait a minute. You sure you never played this game before?
Oh, yeah. Me very sure.
Well, what you got? Four kings. Oh, that's too bad. But you still got a chance. All you gotta do is throw these four kings away. Let's see, just get four more new cards. One, two, three, four. I only have to take three. Ah, yeah, yeah. Now, what you got?
Me win.
Oh, four. You only got four ones. I got four twos, see? Me win. Your deal. Here, deal up. Well, well, well. It's a good game, ain't it? Pretty good cookies, too.
Well, you two seem to be getting along pretty well together.
Yeah, I'm teaching Sing Lo how to play poker. Well, I'll just bet $5 against a whole pan of cookies.
All right, me call. How many cut you won?
I'll play these.
Dealer, catch him four.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself, Porky, taking advantage of poor Sing Lo like this.
Well, I guess I win. I've got a full house.
Oh, so sorry. I catch him 5-1.
Wait a minute. How come you've got five aces when there's only supposed to be four in the deck?
Only four? So sorry. I catch him plenty more aces. You toiling, is she? You toiling, is she? You toy, Lenishi. You toy, Lenishi. You toy, Lenishi. So sorry, me no play poker. Me best magic man from Shanghai. Better luck next time. Goodbye.
You toy, Lenishi. Something tells me I've been bamboozled.
How long are you fellas gonna keep me here?
What do you care? You ain't going anyplace. Hi, Blackie. Your friend here is getting anxious.
Yeah? We'll take care of that. Calhoun, what made you turn outlaw all of a sudden?
For the money that's in it. I figure it's safer being a road agent than a ranger.
You're getting smarter, all right? How would you like to join up with us?
Why should I? I'm doing all right by myself.
You mean you were. The boss figures you ought to work with us. If you don't, you'll never get out of here alive.
So you're not the boss, huh?
Yeah, of course not.
Who gives the orders around here?
As far as you're concerned, I do. Now, what do you say, Calhoun?
Looks like I have no choice.
Now you're talking sense.
What's your proposition?
First, you and me have a job to pull in town tomorrow at the shipping pens. If you make good, we'll work out a deal.
I'll go and get the money now, Joanne. We've only got a few minutes before the bank closes.
All right, Dad. You thought an awful lot of Brand, didn't you, Joan?
But now everything's so changed.
Men are awfully funny. I see a lot of them around the post.
I thought Brand was different.
Well, I think there's more to Brand's actions than appears on the surface. I don't care what Dad says about nerve strain breaking a man down. Brand just isn't the kind to break.
Do you really think he has a reason for what he's done?
Well, around headquarters, Brand always had a reason for what he did. Usually a good one, too.
Rollins, we're going to hold up, huh? Why'd you tell me?
What's the difference? His daughter's through with you anyway.
Thanks, Jim. You can always depend on prime beef from my ranch.
Get ready.
I'll get you for this, Calhoun. It's the last thing I ever do. Ride to the Ranger headquarters and tell them what happened.
What's all the excitement about?
Brand and another man just held us up at the shipping pens.
You mean Brand has you up?
Yes, Dad and Patty just went after them.
You wait here. Come on, Pokey, we're ready.
Somewhere.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. We got the money, haven't we?
No, he's trying to find them. They probably caught up with the rest of the gang.
They got away from us.
She's the best little ranger around here. You'd have let them rob me blind.
Why didn't you let me know you were getting paid off for that herd? I'd have given you a bodyguard.
Too late to cry about it now.
If ever I get my hands on that Calhoun, I'll skin him alive.
Be like trying to pet a wildcat, Mr. Rollins.
Go this time.
Here she is. Went off without a hitch.
What about Calhoun?
Well, that's enough at the hideout. Shall I turn him in now?
Not yet. We've got one last job to do. Our biggest.
What's that?
We're going to take the Palo Verde Bank tomorrow.
That's a big order.
Well, don't worry. I've got it all planned. Now, here's what we do.
Made a hit with the boss, making good on your first job.
I'm glad of that. When am I going to have the pleasure of meeting him?
Maybe after the job tomorrow.
He sure keeps himself scarce around here.
That shows how smart he is.
Who is he anyway?
You'll find out when the time comes. Put that light out. I want to get some sleep.
I'm kind of sleepy myself. Good night.
Thank you. rides along and sings his song while the moon seems to listen and say, a cowboy's happy today. A cowboy is happy when the prairie sky is clear and high and the stars beam and brighten his way. A cowboy's happy today when he's up in his saddle, he is on his throne. With his horse and his gun, of course, he will never feel alone. A cowboy is happy when the trail is wide and he can ride while the wind blows his troubles away. A cowboy's happy today when he's up in his saddle, he is on his throne. With his horse and his gun, of course, he will never feel alone. A cowboy is happy when the trail is wide and he can ride while the wind blows his troubles away. A cowboy's happy today.
Patty, I want you to take this message to Captain McDowell.
I don't think my father'd be interested in anything you'd have to say.
He'll be interested in this. Now, you'll have to ride hard to get to the post before daylight. Now, hurry.
All right.
Joan, I'd like to tell you what this is all about, but I've got to get back to the hideout before they discover I'm missing.
I think I'm beginning to understand. Please be careful.
Blow me up and call me a balloon if that ain't a raspberry pie. Morning, Captain. Fine morning, eh? You mind if I have breakfast with you?
Not at all. Sit right down, Porky. Apple turnover.
Uh-huh.
Just the thing to top off my breakfast.
Uh-huh. Don't you think you better put cream and sugar on it?
No. I always like to eat it this way.
Dad, Brand gave me this note for you. I guess it's important.
Brand. The gang is set to raid the bank at opening time in the morning. I'm stringing along to learn who the leader is. Smoke them up, Captain. Don't worry about me. Brand.
Then his resignation was just part of a plan to get in with the outlaws.
Well, salt me down and call me a mackerel. I must be plumb loco for ever doubting him.
Porky, round up the boys. We got a job to do.
Yes, sir, Captain.
Ready. Get everyone off the street. We don't want anybody hurt. Men, take cover on both sides of the street, where you can watch the entrance to the bank.
Riding up, folks won't get suspicious. So, Dirk, you take your men and come in from the other side of town. Meet us in front of the bank. Wait a minute, Calhoun. You're going with me.
Hey,
stand is.
There's another bunch of them coming down the street.
They've split up.
I don't like the looks of this. Ain't nobody on the street. Maybe you know something about it, Calhoun.
What's the matter? You getting cold feet?
Come on.
It's gonna be tough on Brian when the shooting begins.
I'm afraid of that gang. When they realize he's tipped us off.
Captain, I'm going up here by the grocery store. It's better shooting from there.
Let them have it.
Calhoun must have tipped off the Rangers.
Did they see you come in here?
I don't think so.
They might have. We'd better get out of town. Calhoun.
I thought I'd find the boss of this outfit if I stuck to it long enough. Turn around.
Oh, you tipped off the Rangers, eh?
Yeah, it was a pleasure. Take you to headquarters. Now get out of here.
Thank you. his life out on the prairie, riding on with a song, facing death and danger, and never a fear, though the day be hard and long. With the strength for every hardship, on the trail of the pioneer, from the desert sand to the Rio Grande, along this new frontier. It's a ranger's life on the prairie, riding on with a song, across the plains and mountains, we're helping to build a nation brave and strong. There's a great lone star to guide us, and a love for our Texas home. All free men fight when the cause is right, for life 'neath heaven's dome. A ranger's life to roam.
Brand, I've got some good news for you.
Fine. What is it, sir?
There you are.
Why, this is a commission, appointing me captain of the post.
That's right, son. I'm old enough for retirement. Me and Patty are taking up ranching for a change. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Brand, that's wonderful. Let me pin on your new badge.
Good.
Congratulations, Brand.
Thank you.
I hope you're our captain for a long time.
Thank you.
No, Porky Blake. No stealing pie this time. Me givey.
You mean you're gonna give me pies from now on?
Yes, my friend. This one.
Don't put a finger.